finally arrived at zero.
我们数啊数啊，终于数到零了。
We started back a month ago with number four. That was the arrest.
在大概一个月前吧，我们开始了这个系列的讲道，现在到了最后一讲。
Then we came to number three, which was the Jewish trial.
我们讲到从三开始数的是犹太人的公会的审判。After
that, on number two, we came down to the Roman trial.
然后数到二的时候，我们看的是罗马人的审判。Last
week we had Easter Sunday, the Resurrection Sunday.
上个星期我们是有复活节主日的讲道。And
today we're down to zero, Ascension.
今天我们是数到零了，那是升天。I
hope you were able to be with us for all of these messages because they all fit right together.
我盼望过去的这几个星期大家都是。 听到了这一系列的讲道，因为这几个星期的讲道是连在一起的。The
Lord Jesus Christ, when he was finished with his work here on the earth, he ascended back to be at God's right hand.
当主耶稣基督完成了他在地上所有的事工之后，他就升天，回到父神的右边。
And today we're going to try to answer the question of why did Jesus go back to heaven?
今天我们尝试来回答这个问题，为什么主耶稣要回到天上？
Let's look at the scriptures beginning in Acts chapter 1, verses 8 to 11.
我们一起来看《使徒行传》第一章的第八节。
Read with me, please. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth.
但圣灵降临在你们身上，你们必就必得着能力，并要在耶路撒冷、犹太全地和撒玛利亚，直到地极，做我的见证。
And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight.
第九节，说了这话，他们正看的时候，就被取上升，有一朵云彩把他接去，就便看不见他了。
And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel.
当他往上去，他们定睛望天的时候，忽然有两个人身穿白衣站在旁边说，
Which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven.
加利利人啊，你们为什么站着望天呢？就离开你们被接升天的耶稣，你们见他怎样往天上去，他还要怎样来？
Let us pray and ask God to prepare our hearts.
让我们一起祷告，求主给我们听到的心。
Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for your precious word. 慈悲的天父，我们今天为了你宝贵的话语，我们感谢你。 We ask you to open our spiritual eyes so we might understand your truths. 我们今天求你，主啊，就是打开我们属灵的眼睛，所以我们能看清楚你的话。May you speak, and may we listen. 请你给我们说话，让我们注意听。In Jesus' name we pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求，阿门。阿门。 It is impossible to overstate the importance of Good Friday when Jesus died on the cross.
无论如何，我们都不可能过分的强调耶稣基督在十字架上的死，就是在受难日那一天所发生的事。
It's also just beyond our ability to exaggerate more than it should be when Jesus on the third day rose from the grave.
然后另外还有一件很重要的事，就是三天之后他复活，怎么强调都不可能太过强调这件事的重要性。
But the earthly ministry of Jesus did not end there.
但是主耶稣复活之后，是不是他在地上的所有的事工都完成了呢？没有。
For 40 days after his resurrection, Jesus stayed on the earth, and he went to his disciples, and he taught them. He taught them about the kingdom of God.
在复活之后40天之久，主耶稣都有记载，在不同的时候、不同的地点向他的门徒们显现，教导他们。
Then as we just read, he ascended back to heaven.
然后我们刚才所读的经文就是他升天的经文。Why
did Jesus go back to heaven?
为什么耶稣要升天回到天上？
Jesus went back to heaven, number one, to continue his work.
第一点。 主耶稣回到天上，是因为他要继续他的工作。Look
with me at Acts chapter 1, verses 1 and 2.
我们看《使徒行传》的一开始头两节。The
former treaties have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began to do and teach.
提阿非罗啊。 我已做了前书，论到耶稣开头一切所行所教训的。Until
the day in which he was taken up, after that he, through the Holy Ghost, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen.
直到他借着圣灵吩咐所拣选的使徒以后。 被接上升的日子为止。
Notice the word began in verse number 1.
我们留意一下第一节当中说耶稣开头一切，开头两个字。
We know that on the cross, Jesus, one of the sayings was, it is finished.
我们记得主耶稣在十字架上他说的其中一句话是
He meant that his suffering for the sins of the world were finished.
成了的意思是他为着世人的罪所献上的祭，所为他们所受的苦，这个成了。
He did not mean that his nurture and his loving care for his people was finished.
他不是说他会喂养、会保护、会看顾他的子民，也完成了，不是。When
Jesus ascended back to heaven, two angels told the disciples, "This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go." Into heaven.
在他们目睹了主升天之后，有两个天使对这些人说话。两个天使说的就是说，你们要知道他怎样去，还要怎样来的。
He still loves us, and he is continually working to make us more and more like God wants us to be, holy and righteous.
他对我们的爱没有结束，他继续着爱我们，继续着在我们身上有他的工作，使我们成圣，使我们 得保护，使我们被他爱，等等。
Jesus returned to heaven to continue his work, and number two, to send the Holy Spirit.
主耶稣回到天上，第一点，他会继续他的工作；第二点，他回去是要赐下圣灵。
Luke chapter 24, verse 49.
路加福音24:49.
And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high.
我要将我父所应许的降在你们身上，你们要在城里等候，直到你们领受从上头来的能力。
In Peter's sermon on the on Pentecost, on that day when the Holy Spirit came down, this explains how all those people could hear the message in their own native tongue.
在五旬节的那一天，彼得站起来讲道的时候，也就是彼得说话，他们每个人按照自己的乡谈，他按照自己的那个地方话，听见了彼得的讲道，在使徒行传是这样说的。
In Acts chapter number 2, verse 33, the Bible says, Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted, and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, he has shed forth this, which ye now see and hear.
那天彼得说过，他既被神的右手高举，又从父受了圣，所应许的圣灵，就把你们所听、所看见、所听见的浇灌下来。
800 years before Jesus was born in Bethlehem, the Old Testament prophet Joel revealed something to us in Joel chapter 2, verse number 28.
在主耶稣基督降生800年前，先知约珥已经被圣灵感动记下将来要发生的事。
And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions.
约珥书二章二十八节，以后我要将我的灵浇灌凡有血气的，你们的儿女要说预言，你们的老年人要做异梦，少年人要见异象。
Sending God's Spirit to us was God's promise, and God keeps His promises.
差遣他的灵，浇灌我们，这是上帝应许的事。他说了，他就会做到。
The ascended Lord Jesus Christ, he sent the Holy Spirit to be present with his people.
主耶稣走了之后，他差遣他的圣灵常与他的门徒同在。
Jesus told his disciples in John chapter 14, verse number 16, And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever.
约翰福音14:16，主耶稣就告诉门徒这样说，我要求父，父就另外赐给你们一位保惠师，叫他永远与你们同在。
They needed the Holy Spirit to empower them to evangelize the whole world.
圣灵会引领他们，也使他们有能力将主耶稣的福音传至地极。
Look at Acts chapter 1 verse 8 again.
我们回到刚才所读的《使徒行传》第一章第八节。
But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and unto Samaria, and unto all parts of the earth.
这一节说，但圣灵降临在你们身上，你们就必得着能力，并要在耶路撒冷、犹太全地和撒玛利亚，直到地极，做我的见证。
We need the Holy Spirit to transform us into people that can live the new lives as children of the King.
圣灵降临在我们身上，转化我们，改变我们，让我们得着能力去活一个全新的生命。这个生命是君王儿女的生命。
Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2 exhorts us, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
在罗马书的12章1、2节这样说，所以弟兄们，我以神的慈悲劝你们，将身体献上，当作活祭，是圣洁的，是神所喜悦的。你们如此侍奉，乃是理所当然的。不要效法这个世界，只要心意更新而变化，叫你们查验何为神的善良、纯全、可喜悦的旨意。
Thank God that the Holy Spirit came to help us.
我们感谢神，他差了圣灵来帮助我们。
By His help, we are able to boldly witness and to work and serve our risen Savior.
我有了他的帮助，我们就会有胆量、有能力来宣讲我们主的事迹。我们也能为他做见证。
Jesus returned to heaven to continue his work, send the Holy Spirit, and number three, to take his rightful place.
主耶稣回到天上，第一，他要继续他的工作；第二，他要差遣圣灵；第三，他去他应该在的地方，他要得到他应该得到的位分。
He ascended to heaven and sits on the right hand of God the Father.
他回到天上，他要坐在父神的右边。
When he ascended, he was crowned as the true King of Kings.
当他回到天上的时候，他将要接受冠冕，这个冠冕是万王之王的冠冕。
In Acts chapter number 7, verse 56, Stephen, the first Christian martyr, he said this, Behold, I see heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God.
使徒行传第7章第56节记载，基督徒的第一位殉道者施提反，最后的话，他说，我看见天开了，人子站在神的右边。
The ascension of Jesus Christ falls into line with the end time prophecy given by the prophet Daniel.
耶稣升天，其实在之前的但以理书，在但以理先知的预言里面已经有记载。
Daniel chapter 7, verses 13 to 14. Verse 13 says this, I saw in the night vision, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him before him.
我在但以理书7章13节记载，我在夜间的异象中观看，见有一位像人子的，驾着天云而来，被领到亘古常在者的面前。
Verse 14 says, and there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion, which shall not pass away, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed.
得了权柄、荣耀、国度，使各方各国、各族的人都侍奉他。他的权柄是永远的，不能废去。他的国也必不败坏。
Psalm 110, verse 1 reveals why he's waiting. It says in this verse, the Lord saith unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool.
在诗篇110篇的第一节也有相关的记载，主耶稣为什么要在父神的右边，他在那里干什么等等。 诗篇110篇的第一节，耶和华对我主说：“你坐在我的右边，等我使你仇敌坐你的脚凳。”The
kingdom has been inaugurated, been started through the enthronement of Jesus, who now sits with God on his throne. And will return to establish his kingdom one day and maybe soon.
主耶稣正式就任的，正式登上他万王之王的宝座，现在坐在天上的父神的右边，建立他的国度，只等到他再来到地上。 的那一天,
Amen. That kingdom cannot be destroyed and it will not pass away.
那个国度是不会结束的，也不会被毁坏。
Jesus returned to heaven to continue his work, to send the Holy Spirit, to take his rightful place, and number four, to keep his promise.
主耶稣回到天上，继续他的工作，也差遣他的圣灵。他现在坐在他应该坐的位置上，然后他会实现他的应许，持守他的应许。Before
his death and after his resurrection, Jesus declared that he was sent from the Father and that he must return to the Father.
在他登上十字架之前，在他受死复活之前，主耶稣已经多次的跟门徒说了，他要回到父神那里，他要这件事要成就。
In John chapter 13, verse number 3, the Bible says, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hand, and that he was come from God and went to God.
约翰福音13:3这样记载，耶稣知道父已将万有交在他手里，且知道自己是从神出来的，又要归到神那里。
As recorded in John chapter 16, verse 28, Jesus expressed it this way, I came forth from the Father and am come into the world. Again, I leave the world and go to the Father.
同样在约翰福音16:28也这样记载，主耶稣说，我从父出来到了世界，我又离开世界往父那里去。
The resurrected Jesus said to Mary Magdalene in John chapter 20 and verse 17, Jesus saith unto her, touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren and say to them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father and to my God and your God.
在约翰福音20:17，主耶稣对莫大拉的玛利亚说他复活之后 莫大拉的玛利亚看见他，他就对他说：“不要摸我，因我还没有升上去见我的父。你往我弟兄那里去，告诉他们说，我要升上去见我的父，也是你们的父，见我的神，也是你们的神。
”Amen. Jesus fully accomplished his mission and glorified God the Father here on this earth. So it was time for him to return back home.
主耶稣已经完满的成全完成了他来地上的使命他也荣耀了他的父在地上的事情结束了，现在是时间回到父神那里去。
In John chapter 17, verses 4 and 5, we read Jesus' prayer. He prayed, I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do.
在约翰福音十七章记载主耶稣祷告的话里面，第四节和第五节这样说，第四节，我在地上已经荣耀你，你所托付我的事我已成全了。
And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was.
父啊，现在求你使我同你享荣耀，就是未有世界以先我同你所有的荣耀。
Jesus returned to heaven, number one, because he had work to do. He returned to his work. He returned to heaven to send the Holy Spirit. He also returned there to his rightful place. And he returned there to keep his promise. And number five, he returned to be our mediator and our high priest.
主耶稣回到天上是因为他要继续他的工作在那里，也是因为他要差遣他的圣灵来也是因为他要回到天上坐在他合法的位置上，也是要实现他自己的应许。然后第五点，他要做我在那里做我们的中保和做我们的大祭司。
Jesus is the only mediator between God and man.
在神和人中间只有一位的中保，那就是耶稣基督。
1 Timothy 2:5
在提摩太前书第二章第五节。
For there is one God and one mediator between God and man, the manChrist Jesus.
因为只有一位神，在神和人中间只有一位中保，乃是降世为人的基督耶稣。
His death and resurrection, it secured for us our forgiveness, justification, and reconciliation with God.
他的死和复活是我们在神面前得饶恕、得称义、得以相合的一个保障。
We should also know that the exalted Lord Jesus Christ is now in heaven, interceding for us as we pray. Wherever we are in the world, we can pray, and he is there to hear, no matter what time it is, no matter what our prayer, he hears and intercedes our prayers.
耶稣基督还是我们的大祭司，他为我们，替我们祷告。如今，我们这些在地上的子民，无论我们在什么地方，我们祷告，什么，他都做我们的大祭司，为着我们，帮助我们，甚至替我们祷告。
He truly is our high priest and our advocate.
他是我们的大祭司，他真的是我们在神，我们和神中间 的这一位中保。
Romans 8:34 says this, who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us.
罗马书八章三十四节，谁能定他们的罪呢？有基督耶稣已经死了，并且从死里复活，现今在神的右边，也替我们祈求。
During Jesus' earthly ministry, his ministry area was very small. It was all wrapped up just in the promised land.
耶稣基督在世的时候，我们看见他在地上服侍的这个地理范围好像很小，都是在巴勒斯坦的这个地区，然后他所服侍的都是犹太人这个人群。
But now he is at work everywhere and able to hear and respond to his people's prayers, no matter what time or where they are.
但是现在，如今他可以在全世界的任何一个地方，在任何一个时间，跟任何一位信他的人为他一起与为他们祷告，替他们做上帝和人之间的中保。
Okay, so we've already seen that Jesus returned to heaven to continue his work, to send the Holy Spirit to take his rightful place, to keep his promise, to be our mediator and high priest. And number six, prepare a place for us.
主耶稣回到天上，继续他的工作，也差遣圣灵，也坐在他应该坐的位置上，他完成了他要完成他所应许的，然后他现在做了我们的中保和大祭司。然后我们看第六点，他回到天上是为我们预备地方去。
Jesus in John 14:1-3 said this, let not your heart be troubled.
约翰福音14:1-3第一节说，你们心里不要忧愁。
Believe, ye believe in God.
你们信神。
Believe also in me.
也当信我。
In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you.
在我父的家里有许多住处，若是没有，我就早已告诉你们了。我去原是为你们预备地方去。
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also.
我若去为你们预备了地方，就必再来接你们到我那里去。我在哪里，也就在叫你们也在那里。
We have been looking for a larger church for a long time.
我们教会寻找一个大一点的教堂已经有好一段时间了。
But I read about another church. It was that they were wanting a church, and it took a long time for them to build that church.
我读教会通信的时候，我知道另外有一个教会，他们花了好长的时间来建造他们的教堂。
It wasn't in our lifetime. It was much, much earlier. In the year 1163 AD, architects and builders began to construct what is known as Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris, France.
他们建的这个教堂不在我们这个年代，而是在很久很久以前，在1163年，这个他们开始兴建这个我们都听说过的非常著名的教堂，巴黎圣母院。
It took almost 200 years to complete. And when it was finished, everyone said it was an architectural masterpiece.
这个教堂花了200年的时间建成，建成之后，人们去观看的时候，才发现这一个教堂的建筑、设计，都是相当伟大，没办法，比当时的能力要大的。
This magnificent church, April 15th, 2019, burned.
2019，这个教堂在2019年的4月15号被焚烧。
It is currently being reconstructed, and they are planning to reopen it on in April of
2024。他们现在正在花时间去重修这个教堂，他们想说2024年的4月份，可以重开。
It was beautiful, but it wasn't indestructible.
这个教堂是非常的美丽，很美丽，但是它不是不能被摧毁的。
Jesus said he's gone to prepare a place for us.
主耶稣说他要为我们预备地方去。We
can't imagine how magnificent it is.
我们很难去想象他为我们预备的地方有多好。It
is not only beautiful beyond belief, but it is indestructible.
那个地方肯定不单单只非常的美丽，而且是不能被摧毁的。
Jesus returned to heaven to continue his work, to send the Holy Spirit, to take his rightful place, to keep his promise, to be our mediator, our high priest, to prepare a place for us. And number seven, to wait for his return to earth.
然后我们看到主耶稣回到天上。 第一是继续他的工作，第二差遣圣灵，第三坐在他合法的位置上，第四完成他的应许，第五做我们的中保和大祭司，第六是为我们预备地方。现在来到第七，等在那里等候他回来再来的日子。
In Acts chapter 1, verse number 11, two angels said to the disciples, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven.
我们刚才所读的《使徒行传》，主耶稣升天之后，两个天使对门徒们这样说：加利利人呐！ 你们为什么站着望天呢？这离开你们被接升天的耶稣，你们见他怎样往天上去，他还要怎样来。In
the book of Revelation, chapter number 11 and verse number 15, it says this, and the seventh angel sounded, and there were great voices in heaven, saying, the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever.
启示录11章第5节，第七位天使吹号，天上就有大声音说：世上的国成了我主和主基督的国，他要做王，直到永永远远。
Again, we read in Revelation chapter 19, verses 11 to 16, and I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness doth judge and make war.
在19章的11节，我观看，见天开了，有一匹白马，骑在马上的称为诚实，诚信真实，他审判征战都按着公义。
His eyes were as a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns. And he had a name written that no man knew but he himself.
他的眼睛如火焰，他头上戴着许多冠冕，又有写着的名字，除了他自己，没有人知道。
And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood.And his name is called the Word of God.
他穿着溅了血的衣服，他的名称为神之道。
And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean.
在天上的众军骑着白马，穿着细麻衣，又白又洁。跟随他。
It's kind of strange that it says that they were this army was clothed in fine linen, white and clean. Those don't sound like a battle garments to me.
这里圣经的描述这个军队，穿的是又白又洁净的细麻衣，怎么看这个军队都不像是去打仗的。
The reason is because they're not going to fight. Jesus is.
原因是因为他们不会去打仗。那个真正征战的，身上有血的衣服的，那位是耶稣。
Verse 15 says, And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nations.And he will rule them with a rod of iron, and he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God.
有第十五节，有利剑从他口中出来，可以击杀列国。他必用铁杖辖管他们，并要踹全能神烈怒的酒炸。
And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of kings and Lord of lords.
在他衣服和大腿上有名写着说万王之王，万主之主。
When you pray the Lord's Prayer, and I hope you do, you're asking for this.
当你的祷告用主祷文的时候，我盼望大家都有用过主祷文啊。你说的是这样。
Matthew chapter 6 verse 10, we say, Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
其中有一句是这样说的，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。
When Jesus returns, he will execute a divine judgment, vindicate his downtrodden people, and judge his enemies.
主耶稣再来的时候，他会行使他神圣的审判，他要为他被践踏的子民伸冤，他要审判他的敌人们。
So let's apply it. What does this mean for our lives?
我们看了主耶稣回到天上的原因，那这对我们的生活意味着什么呢？
Let me mention four things in closing.
让我在结束之前做四点的总结。
Number one, remember Jesus is still actively involved in the lives of believers, your life and mine, if we believe.
第一点，我们要记住，耶稣基督今天仍然参与我们的生活，他积极的参与我们的生活。
Number two, Because we know that, therefore, live boldly, confidently, and strategically as servants of the exalted King of Heaven.
第二点, 因此我们要作为天国崇高之王的仆人, 我们要放胆笃信, 并有策略的来生活。
1 Corinthians 15:58 puts it this way, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
所以，哥林多前书15:58，所以我亲爱的弟兄们，你们务要坚固，不可动摇，常常竭力，多做主工，因为知道你们的劳苦在主里面。 不是突然的.
Number three, suffer. God speaking to you and me. Know that Jesus is not indifferent to our struggle.
我们要知道主耶稣知道我们的挣扎.
He has endured great suffering and is truly able to be merciful and sympathetic as our counselor and as our mediator.
他自己也受过苦难，他不会不管我们，他是最能同情、最能明白我们的受苦，他也做我们的谋士。
Therefore, take your cares, your problems, your suffering to the ascended Lord who hears your prayers and can respond with all of heaven's power and authority.
所以我们一定要带着我们的祈求，我们的祷告来到这一位已经升到天上的主宰面前，我们 向他求告，他会回应我们，以他天上的能力、天上的权柄来帮助我们。Number
four,
第四点。
Finally, the ascended Lord will return as judge and king.
最后，这一位升到天上的主，他会 作为我们，作为审判官和王再回来。
He will abolish injustice, end suffering, and destroy death, and set up his kingdom of truth, righteousness, and love.
他要结束那一些不公正，他要结束所有的苦难，他要使死亡灭亡。 他要建立他的国度，他的国度是真实的，是公义的，是爱的国度。
And best of all, we will be with our Lord forever.
最要紧的是他再来的时候，我们将要与我们的主、我们的王永远在一起，直到没有穷尽。
Someone said, "Forever is a long time."
有人说。 永远是一段好长的时间啊。It
sure is.
是的，是一段好长的时间。The
question for us today is, how will your forever be?
但是今天的问题，可能是你的永远要在哪里过呢？
Forever blessed in the presence of the Lord, or forever suffering the wrath of Almighty God.
我们是永远在一位公义的主宰面前受祝福呢？还是永远的在上帝全能的上帝的震怒里面活着呢？
It is a personal decision that everyone must make.
那这个是个 个人的决定，每个人要自己下的。Let
us pray.
我们祷告。Gracious
Heavenly Father, we thank you for speaking very plainly to us through your word. 天父，我们感谢你，你就是很 他很坦白的给我们说话。 We pray that each of us will think about it and understand it. 我们盼望人们都会好好的思想这个道理是什么意思。 We pray, Father, that you will let the Holy Spirit guide us to understand. 求你的圣灵能够带领我们理解这个话。 And Lord, I pray that Christians will be empowered by knowing that we serve the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. 我盼望基督徒们都能够得力，因为我们知道我们的主是万王之王，万王之主。 Help us, Lord, to stand up and glorify Him. 帮助我们站起来，荣耀他的名。 Father, we pray that those that are not yet saved will understand their problem. 我盼望那还没得罪人可以理解他们的危险。 Help them understand that they can have God's love or God's wrath. 帮助他们明白他们能够得神的爱或是神的愤怒。 It all depends on what they do with Jesus. 这个就是他们对耶稣怎么样会决定。 Father, we pray that the lost will be saved. 我们今天求你拯救那些还没得罪人。 We pray that Christians will be strengthened. 我们求你帮助基督徒们得力。 In Jesus' name we pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求, Amen.
Amen.
If you have questions or needs, please call us. If you don't understand how to be saved, call. We'll try to help you.
如果你们有问题，需要帮助的话，请联系我们。 那个代祷事项或者需要什么的，屏幕上面是我教会的联系方式和号码。Gracious
Father, we thank you for the promise that our Lord Jesus will someday come. 天父，我们感谢你，你给我们应许，我们的宝贵的耶稣有一天会再来。Lord, our prayer with the Apostle John is come quickly. 我们的祷告像约翰的祷告一样，请你快来。In Jesus' name we pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求，阿门。